Hi, I'm Gavin from Voxon Photonics, and today I'm going to show you how to use Blender to make an animation that will run on our VX1 volumetric display. I'm using Blender 2.78c and version 2.1 of the Voxon SDK. So let's get started. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using a cloth physics demo from littlewebhut.com. The animation is 250 frames long, and we're going to export each of those frames as an STL file. To do this, first we'll need to install a free script that you can download from the link shown below. Once you have downloaded it, navigate to the User Preferences menu and click Install from File. Select the script, click the Install button, and finally save the user settings. You should now be able to find the script by hitting space and typing export, and selecting Exporting Frames as Mesh Files. When you hit enter, you might think Blender has crashed, but don't worry, it's just very busy exporting your frames. After a short wait, you should find that your project directory is full of STL files. Along with your files, you're going to need an info.ini file, which looks like this. This file has some extra information about the animation, like its speed and playback mode. The next thing to do is select all the STL files and the info.ini file and zip them up. I'm using the free 7-zip archiver. Once complete, copy the zip file to the media section of the SDK and run VoxiOS, the volumetric file browser. If you then navigate to the animation folder, you can find and run your animation. Because the animation is made up of STL files, you can use the density slider from the render menu to adjust the brightness. This function subdivides the triangles in the file. Okay, that's enough of the simulator. Let's transfer the animation to the VX1 on a USB stick and see how it looks. Thanks for watching. We'll be right back.